Previously, we had a test script that we were testing the dice function with six-sided dice, eight-sided die, and we, as you can see, they have the same code here, copied, pasted again and again. Usually, then it's a good move to move it into a function, and because we're checking whether it's any of the received value is any of the values that we are expecting, we're going to call this function isAny. So the way we're going to use it is any, we are going to call the isAny function, pass it the actual value, pass it the expected values, but because it is easier to pass a reference, so we pass the reference to value, and we can even pass a test, so test name, correct number, any text we can put. And that's the way we are going to call it. And the rest of the three lines, this is going to be actually the content of the subroutine. So isAny is going to be the function. Now we're going to get the three parameters. The first one is the actual value. We call it actual here, not the value, it's actual value. The second one are the expected values, which is a reference to an array, so this is a scalar value. And then the name of the test, which is optional. Now, because it's optional, we should actually tell Perl that it should be the empty string if it's not given, so when we print it out, we won't try to print an undef if the user didn't pass it. And then instead of this code, now I'm going to put this in parentheses just to be clearer, and the third parameter here is the actual name. And because of the way the any function works, we also have to put it in parentheses, otherwise it won't work correctly. Now instead of value, we have the name actual, and here too. And instead of the expected array, we have a reference to an array that we need to dereference, and the same happens here too. So now we moved out the content of that test into a subroutine, and we're calling the subroutine. And if everything works fine, then this will work. And here we are, it printed out the eight expected numbers. And in these cases, the six expected numbers is still printed out by the old code, which was the copied version. Now we don't really need that anymore, so we can remove these three lines, and instead of that, copy just the call to the isAny function. And we can just make sure everything is fine. So there's six, the eight, the six part, the eight-sided die, everything is there. But the code is much more compact, and we can reuse this isAny function in more test cases. Now everything looks good, except of one thing. If you see this screen, you can see that it reported that the test failed on line 27. And here too, when it was testing the eight-sided, it again reported line number 27. But they are not in the same place. So what's on line 27? That's actually the isAny function, where we call the OK, well, it shows this line, but where we call the OK function, that's the place when it's reporting, instead of where we call the isAny function. Now, if you know how Perl looks at the stack, the call stack, then you know that there is a caller function, and you can give it how many levels back in the call stack you want to look. And this is basically how the OK function works, or the thing behind the OK function works, that it knows how far back the OK function was called, and that's where it's going to report the location of the OK call. And what we need to do is we need to tell it that look at one step even further, because now we want it to look at where the isAny function was called. And we can do that by using the back end of this system. So the whole test simple framework has a backend which is called the test builder. And the test builder has a variable called test builder level. So we can take this test builder level and increase it by one. And if you do that, it will report the test in the correct place. But there is an issue here. If you just increment this number, that will make the change for all the tests, even if you are calling is or okay outside of the isAny function. So that's really not the right thing to do. It's probably better to increment, but in a different way. So increment it by one, but localize the new version. So we localize the new level variable, or the level variable. So when we leave the isAny function, this increment will just go away. Now if you run the test script, it already reports here that this was reported at line 18, this to line 18, line 18, these all the 8 versions, and the 6-sided version is reporting on line 12. So we've improved this test function by providing the correct place of the test failure.